And now to our NewsHour Shares. When two black bears were burned in a California wildfire, veterinarians used a treatment never tried before on animals. Our Julia Griffin explains.
December's Thomas Fire was the largest on record in California, scorching more than 280,000 acres and destroying more than 1,000 homes. But while most human residents could escape the inferno, two black bears rescued by the California Department of Fish and Wildlife weren't so lucky. Trapped by the flames, they had suffered severe second and third degree burns to their paws.
This is all that's left of her normal path.
For UC Davis veterinarian Jamie Payton, addressing the bear's injuries would require outside-the-box thinking, namely treating the burns with tilapia skins.
The bear, I will tell you, is probably the one that really inspired me to look into the tilapia bandages, because her wounds were so extensive and her pain was so severe. She was the one that made me say, you know what, I need to do something else. What else can I do?
Payton knew doctors in Brazil had seen success in treating human burn victims with sterilized tilapia skin and was keen to try it on her animal patients.
If you look at the literature, treating wild animals that have experienced this degree of burns just hasn't been done.
The collagen in tilapia skin acts like a biological bandage, protecting and moisturizing the skin while promoting healing. And in this instance, Payton wrapped the sutured wounds with corn husks to delay her patients' attempts to eat their edible dressings. Positive results were almost immediate.
Nothing is more rewarding than when you take an animal that won't walk because she's so painful, and we try a new therapy. I put those bandages, the tilapia skin, on her feet, and right after we got done and she woke up, she stood up for the first time and was able to walk.
A speedy recovery was crucial. Limiting the bear's time in captivity would greatly improve their chances of long-term survival, especially since one was pregnant and would be better off delivering in the wild. So while Payton oversaw the bear's final treatment, Fish and Wildlife officials set in motion plans to release them, building two man-made, bear-approved dens 5 miles apart in unburned portions of Los Padres National Forest.
My sweetheart, you're a good girl.
Sedated and secured, all that was left to do was deliver the bears to their new homes.
Coming up.
Her patients discharged, Payton reflected on the success of her unique treatment plan.
The tilapia skin, in my opinion, is one of those things that, you know, people said to me, what? That doesn't make sense. You can't do that. And when someone says you can't, I always think to myself, oh, I will. And I'll make it happen because I'm just passionate about these animals and about helping them and allowing them to heal.
The California Department of Fish and Wildlife continues to monitor the bear's progress with trail cameras and GPS trackers. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Julia Griffin.